So hi children, so today we are going to discuss about the first unit, so in our science, that is living things. So in this unit we are going to discuss about green plants. So today our lesson is about green plants. So in this lesson we will discuss about what are the different types of plants. What are the different types of plants grown in different regions, and what are their characteristics, and how they growing? So these are the some important topics we are going to discuss in this lesson. So green plants. So green plants. So children, we will observe plants everywhere in our surroundings. That is, you will observe the plants in your house, in your school, in your garden and parks, and also forest also. Particularly in our regions, the plants we observed are, so frequently observed plants in our region, that means in our area, are mango tree, guava tree and papaya, orange tree, so neem tree, so and some flower trees, etc. So we are observing very frequently these type of trees in our regions, that is in our areas. And throughout the world there are different types of regions and different types of places. So some plants grown in some area and some plants grown in other area. For example, we can observe that some plants will grow in hill areas, that is in mountain areas. So mountain areas, and some plants grown in water, and some plants grown in ice cold regions, and some plants will grow in plain areas, that means in plains. So we will observe that different types of plants will grow in different types of regions throughout the world. And we will observe some plants especially grown in mountains, and some plants especially grown in water, and some plants especially grown in ice cold regions, and some plants especially grown in plain areas. That means the plants which are grown in one area cannot grow in another area. That means the plants which are growing in mountain areas cannot be grown in water areas, and the plants which are living in water area, they cannot be grown in ice cold regions, and the plants which are grown in ice cold regions, they cannot be grown in plain regions. So the plants which are growing in one region cannot be grown in another region, because in throughout the world we have different types of regions, and in each region the climatic conditions are different, and different climatic conditions and different environmental conditions are present in different regions. Because in mountain areas the climatic conditions are different, the temperature is different, and also in ice cold regions the temperature is different, the atmosphere also different. So in this way, each region has different types of climatic conditions and different types of atmospheres and different types of environments. So the plants growing in a particular region will develop some special features to survive in that particular region. So that special features that are grown in the by plants are called adaptations. So adaptations. So the plants which are growing in a particular region will develop some special features to survive in that climatic conditions and to survive in that environmental conditions. So that special features developed by the plants in that particular region are called adaptations. And the place where the plants particularly grown in that region are called habitats or habitations. So habitation is a place where a particular type of plants grow. So habitation is a place where a particular type of plants will grow. So in this way, in each habitation, the plants growing in each habitation will have some special adaptations to survive in the climatic conditions and in the environmental conditions in that habitation. The plants growing in one habitation cannot be grown in another habitation. For example, the plants grown in mountain habitation cannot be grown in water habitations. And the plants which are growing in plains cannot be grown in ice cold region habitations. So because the regions have different, and the different regions have different climatic conditions, and the trees or plants which are growing in a particular habitation will have some special adaptations. So that means the mango tree cannot be grown in ice cold regions, and the apple trees cannot be grown in our regions. That's why. So this is the reason some plants cannot be grown in particular regions. So now we will deal about what are the different types of plants. So by depending upon their habitations, the plants are divided into particularly three types. So by depending upon the habitations, the trees are especially divided into three types, and the three types are, so the first one is terrestrial plants. So depending upon the habitations of the plants are divided into three types. So there are three types of plants, and the first one is terrestrial plants, and the second one is aquatic plants, and the third type of plants are insectivorous plants. So these are the three types of plants which are divided on the basis of their habitations. So one is a terrestrial plant, and second type is aquatic plants, and third one is insectivorous plants. Now we will discuss about the first type of plants, that is terrestrial plants. So terrestrial plants. So what are terrestrial plants? So terrestrial means land. So that means the plants which grow on the land are called terrestrial plants. So which grow on the land. So which grow on the land are called terrestrial plants. So these terrestrial plants includes grasses, shrubs, herbs, etc. So these terrestrial plants are again divided into four types. So the four types of terrestrial plants are, the first one is desert plants, and the second one is plants of plains, and the third one is plants of hills. So plants of hill areas, and fourth one is plants of marshy areas. So plants of marshy areas, and So these are the four types of terrestrial plants. So first one is desert plants, and second one is plants of plains, and the third one is plants of hill areas, and fourth one is plants of marshy areas. So now let us discuss about what are desert plants. So what are desert plants? So terrestrial means land. On the land we have different types of habitations. That means we have water habitations, and we have deserts and plains and mountains. So different types of habitations present on the terrestrial. So depending upon their habitations, again the terrestrial plants are divided into four types. So the first one is desert plants. So let us discuss about first desert plants. So in deserts, so we have already known about deserts. So in our country also there is a desert, that is in Rajasthan state. So you have already observed in cinemas also. So what does the desert contains? So the desert has mainly sand. And how will be the temperature in the desert? So the temperature is very high. So in desert especially, the land contains only sand, and the temperature is very high, and the water content, that is the availability of water, is very very less. So in deserts, the climate is very hot, and water availability is very less, and particularly the soil is sand. And so that's why the desert plants, so the plants which are grown in such type of climatic conditions, are the example for the desert plants is cactus. So one is cactus plant. So cactus plant, so look at the picture. So in picture you are observing the shape and the structure of a cactus plant. So we will frequently observe this type of plants in desert. So the first one is cactus plants. So in the figure you are observing the stem of these plants is very very less. So carefully observe the picture. They have, the cactus trees have, the stem is very very less, and the stem is in green color, and the stem is very soft and thicky, because these cactus plants stores water in their stems. That's why their stem is very strong and thicky and soft, and these stems does not contains any branches. That means no branches, very less branches. And the leaves, this cactus plants does not contains leaves, and the leaves are reduced to spines. So look at the picture. The cactus plants does not have any leaves like structure. They have spines. That means in this type of plants, the leaves are reduced to spines. Because if these plants have leaves, the water present in their stem will be lost through evaporation, through respiration. So to prevent the loss of water through evaporation or respiration, these plants does not contain leaves, and the leaves are reduced into the shape of spines. So these spines prevent these trees the loss of water due to evaporation or respiration. And these spines also prevent these plants from the grazing of animals, desert animals. So these are the special features. So these are the adaptations in the desert plants to survive in such very hot climatic conditions, and in very less availability, water availability regions. And these cactus plants have very longer roots. So observe carefully, the roots are very long, and these long roots are goes deep into the deeper regions of the soil. so that they can absorb the water which are present at the very depth places of the soil. So this is about cactus plant. So this cactus plants, and another example for the desert plant is also palm tree. So palm tree is also grown in the desert, and cactus plants also grown in the desert. So this is about desert plants. So the desert plants especially does not have any leaves, because if there are any leaves, the water will be lost through the evaporation or respiration. So this is about desert plants. Generally, plants prepare their food by using the process called photosynthesis. So by using this process, that means by using photosynthesis, plants prepare their food. So this photosynthesis process will take place in the leaves, that means in the green parts of the plants. Generally in plants, the leaves are in green color. So this photosynthesis process will especially take place in the green color part of the plant. So the green color part of the plants are nothing but leaves. But desert plants does not have leaves. Then how did the desert plants prepare their food? And they didn't have any leaves. And how can they prepare food? So desert plants prepare their food with the help of stems, because in desert plants the stem is in green color. So in desert plants the stem is in green color, and the photosynthesis process will take place in stems. So desert plants prepare their food in their stems, because in desert plants there are no leaves, and the leaves are reduced to spines. So that's why the photosynthesis process in desert plants, especially in cactus. So in cactus, the photosynthesis process will take place in their stem, because the stem is in green color. So that's why their stem is thick and fleshy, because they store water and food in their stems. So this is about desert plants. So the second type of terrestrial plants. So the second type of terrestrial plants is plants of plains. So plants of plain. So these are the second type of terrestrial plants. So plants of plains means the plants which are grown on the land. So the plants which are grown on the land are called plants of plain. And these plants are also called as mesophytes. So these plants are also called as mesophytes. And these are many type of plants. So these plants have many kinds of plants. And these plants have especially a lot of branches. So these plants have lot of branches, and these plants have lot of leaves also. So these plants of plants are many types of plants. So the plants of plants are different kinds in our surroundings. So especially these type of plants have a lot of branches and a lot of leaves. And these plants shed their leaves in winter season. So these plants shed their leaves in winter season to prevent the loss of water. So these plants especially shed their leaves in winter season, because if the leaves are present, the respiration, the process of respiration takes place. That means the water present in the plant goes out. So that's why these plants, especially in winter season, shed their leaves to prevent the loss of water during respiration or evaporation. So the examples for the plants of plain. So the examples for the plants of plain are, so especially the first example. So the first example is, so banyan tree. So banyan tree. So this is one example for plants of pain. So look at the picture. So the picture, you are observing banyan tree. So banyan tree is also called as the national tree of our India. So banyan tree is also called as national tree of our India. So it is also called as national tree. And we can observe this banyan tree especially by roadside and in villages. And this banyan tree produces a red color fruits which are inedible. That means we should not eat that red color fruits. And banyan tree is one of the largest supplier of oxygen. So banyan tree has a specialty. So this is a largest supplier of oxygen. That means banyan tree supplies more quantity of oxygen than another plants. So that's why this is one of the largest supplier of oxygen. And banyan tree grows to a more size. So it can grow up to a more size. That's why it gives shadow to the people in summer season. So it gives shadow. It gives shadow and protect the people from the hot sun in summer season. So it is a source of shadow during summer seasons. So if you observe the picture, in the picture you are observing a rope-like structures are hanging from the branches of the tree. So these ropes are nothing but aerial roots. So these ropes are also called aerial roots. So these are called aerial roots. So especially in villages, the children are playing with ropes and they make the ropes as cradles and they will swing in that cradles. And this aerial roots give support to the banyan tree, because banyan tree is a huge large sized tree, and the root which is present at its bottom under the soil is not enough to give support to such a huge banyan tree. That's why these aerial roots give support to the banyan tree. So these aerial roots produced from the branches of the trees. And after some years or some days, they will go inside to the soil and give a strong support to the banyan tree. So this is about banyan tree. We can observe this banyan tree across the in our India. So we can see banyan tree all over India, everywhere in India, especially by roadside in villages, we will observe this banyan tree. And the second example for the plants is mango tree. The second example is mango tree. So all of us will know how the mango tree is. So mango tree is also a huge tree. It can grow up to a large size. So mango tree is also an example for the plants which grow on the plains. And another example is sheesam tree. So sheesam trees. So look at the picture. So the picture, you are observing a sheesam tree. It is also just look like a banyan tree. It is also a huge tree. And another example for the plants of plains is peepal tree. Peepal tree. So all of you observe this tree, especially in temples, because it can be treated as a sacred tree. So it has a significant importance in Hindu mythology. So that's why we will chant this tree in the temples, and we will especially observe in temples this peepal tree. So if you observe the peepal tree, so it also grown up to a large size. So the lifespan of the peepal tree is nearly 2000 years. So a peepal tree can grow up to 2000 years. So the lifespan of peepal tree is very, very large. In the same way, the lifespan of banyan tree is also very, very large. So for especially peepal tree, the lifespan is very, very large. That means it can grow up to 2000 years, and it can grow up to a large size, huge size. And this paper thing has a special property. So all plants will produce oxygen especially during daytime, and during night time all the plants releases carbon dioxide. But papal tree especially releases oxygen during night time also. So this is the one of the great speciality of the papal tree. So papal tree releases oxygen both in daytime and also during in night time also. So this is the speciality of the papal tree. So the papal tree is also so many benefits in medicinal purposes. Its seeds, its bark, and all are used in medicines in treatment of skin infections. Especially we will use papal tree, and also banyan tree is also used in medicinal treatments. So this is about plants of plains, the second type of terrestrial plants. So the third type of terrestrial plants, the third type of terrestrial plants are plants of hilly areas. So plants of hilly areas, so these plants especially grown in hilly areas. So these plants especially grown in hilly areas, and we will observe in these areas the frequently rains. So these areas we will frequently observe rains. And these plants are very tall and strong, and also in conical shape. So these plants are tall, strong, and in conical shape. So that's why these plants are also called as coniferous trees, since these are in conical shape. So these trees are also called coniferous trees. So the examples for the plants which are grown in hill areas are, so the first example is pine trees. So one is pine trees. So look at the picture. So in the picture you are observing a pine tree. So the pine tree, if you observe the pine tree is very tall and long, and the shape of the pine tree is in conical shape. So pine tree. And the second example is spruce tree. So spruce tree. So look at the picture. So in the picture you are observing a spruce tree. So it is also in conical shape, and also tall and strong. And the third example is fir tree. Fir tree. So this is also grown in hill areas especially. So you are in the picture, you are observing a fir tree. So look at the picture. So the picture is showing a fir tree. So it is also in the shape of a cone. And the fourth example is cedar. Cedar tree. So it is also example for plants which are grown in hill areas. So these are the examples for the plants which are growing in hill areas. So pine trees, so spruce tree, and fir tree, and cedar tree, and also deodar tree. Deodar tree. So all these are examples for the plants which are grown in hill areas. And if you observe the pictures of these plants, so you are observing the pictures of these plants. So if you observe the pictures, all these plants are in conical shape, and all the plants are very tall and strong. And the leaves of these plants are in blade like shape. So blade like shape. So the leaves are in blade like shape. That means the leaves are very narrow, and they are in blade like shape. And if the snow falls on these trees in that areas, so if the snow falls on these trees and they did not allow the snow to stay on them, and the snow will falls off, that means slide off easily into to the underground of the soil, that is at the bottom of the plant. So because the leaves are in blade like shape, the leaves does not allow the snow fall on them, and the snow will slide off easily and fall down at the bottom of the tree. And these plants does not shed leaves. So does not shed leaves. So these plants does not shed leaves. So if the plants does not shed leaves, like mango trees, banana tree, and neem tree, orange trees, the plants which are grown in plains will shed their leaves in particular season to prevent the loss of water. But these plants does not shed leaves. But then what happens? And what happens to the water present in it? Because these leaves, especially these leaves, have a thin wax coating on it. So these leaves have a thin wax coating on it. That's why the water did not loss during evaporation or during respiration. So the water did not loss it because of this wax coating on the leaves. So these are so that's why these plants does not shed leaves. That's why these plants are also called evergreen trees. Evergreen trees. So because they does not shed their leaves, they always, that means in every season, they remain in green color. And why? Because they does not shed their leaves, and all the green color leaves are attached to the plant. So in every season, in any time, every time throughout the year, the plants look like green because of the leaves. That's why these plants are also called evergreen trees. Evergreen trees. So this is about plants of hilly areas. So this is about plants of hilly areas. Generally these plants, so generally these plants will observe in hill areas, especially in our India. So if you take our India, in our India we will observe these plants in hill stations. In our India, the most travel, that means the tourist hill stations are Mussoorie and Kodaikanal, Nainital, Simla, etc. These are the hill stations in our India. If you go to these places, that means if you go to Simla, or if you go to Nainital, or Kodaikanal, Darjeeling, if you go to any one of the hill stations, you can observe these plants, pine trees, spruce tree, fir tree, cedar tree, deer tree, and we can observe in cinemas also, in hill stations we can observe these trees. So this is about the plants of hilly areas. So this is about plants of hilly areas. So the fourth type of terrestrial plants are plants of marshy areas. So this is the fourth type of terrestrial plants, that is plants of marshy areas. Plants of marshy areas. So in these regions, so marshy regions means, so what are marshy areas? So what are marshy regions? So marshy regions have a lot of water. So marshy regions have a lot of water with wet clay. With wet clay. So marshy areas contains a lot of water and a wet clay, especially sticky clay. Sticky clay. And this sticky soil does not allow the roots of the plants to breathe. So that's why the roots of these plants, that means the plants which are growing in marshy areas, the plants of those areas, the roots of those plants will come out of the soil and will come out of the water level for breathing. So that's why the roots of these plants are called breathing plants. That means, sorry, breathing roots. So breathing roots, because this wet grass or sticky, this wet clay or sticky clay does not allow the roots of these plants for breathing. That's why the roots of these plants come out of the soil and come out of the water level, and they breathe oxygen for them. So that's why these roots are called breathing roots. And the examples for the plants which are grown in marshy areas are mangroves. So all you have know about mangroves. So mangroves. So these are the examples for the plants which will grow in marshy areas. Mangroves. So look at the picture. So in the picture you are observing a mangrove plants. So mangrove plants, if you are observing the mangrove plants, you will observe this mangrove plants in mangrove forest. So if you observe the picture, if you observe that the bottom of the plants, the roots are come outside for breathing. That's why those roots are called breathing roots. And especially in our India, that means especially in our India, the largest mangrove forest is Sundarban forest. So the largest mangrove forest present in our India is Sundarban forest. So Sundarban forest. So these are also called Sundarban mangroves. So the Sundarban mangroves are present in West Bengal. So in West Bengal, there is a large Sundarban forest. The Sundarban forest has especially contains Sundarban mangroves. So West Bengal. So the Sundarban mangroves, that means Sundarban forest, is the one of the largest mangrove forest in our India and also in world also. So this is Sundarban mangroves, that means Sundarban forest, is the one largest mangrove forest in the world. And in our Andhra Pradesh, in our Andhra Pradesh also has a mangrove forest near Kakinada. So in Andhra Pradesh, so we will observe these mangroves in Kakinada at Koringa. So we have a Koringa mangrove forest. So Koringa mangrove forest at Kakinada in Andhra Pradesh. So in our Andhra Pradesh, there is also a mangrove forest called Koringa forest. That Koringa forest is present in Kakinada. So this is about mangroves. And these mangroves are especially grown at the regions where a river joins into the sea. So where the river and seas joins, at that regions these mangroves will grow. So these mangroves are also called the gods of coast. So these mangroves are also called the gods of coast. So gods of coast, because so these mangroves will protect the banks of rivers from the soil erosion due to the tides in the ocean. So that's why these mangroves are also called gods of coast, because mangroves protects the coast from the soil erosion due to the tides of tides in the oceans. So this is about mangroves. See, mangroves is example for the plants which are grown in marshy areas. And another example for these plants is sundari trees. Sundari. So sundari trees. So this is also one of the type of mangrove trees. So sundari trees. Sundari trees. So this is the second example. So look at the picture. In the picture, you are observing a sundari trees. These are also looking like mangrove trees. Next, Third example for this plants is rhizophore plants. So rhizophore plants. So these are also looks like mangrove plants. So look at the picture. In the picture, you are observing rhizophore plants. So these are also look like mangrove plants. So all these are examples. So for the marshy plants, that means the plants growing in marshy areas. So this is about the plants growing in marshy areas. So first episode in this chapter is completed. So the next episode will be continued in the next.